Into the party. It's the birthday of dear Mother Mary. Come on, let's dance, it's a fiesta. Feliz cumpleaños, Maria.
Maria,
Maria, la milagrosa. Maria, la madre de Dios.
The secondary mission thrust of the Jubel and Friends Foundation Incorporated is the Prayer Sanctuary, a place of worship and meditation. The first prayer sanctuary built by the Yub Foundation is here in Acad Aurora, Zamboanga del Sol. In this sanctuary is a replica chapel of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. It was constructed in November of 2016. The construction is still going on. To honor our Blessed Mother, the devotees have their 2000 Hail Mary Rosary devotion every Saturday in this chapel.
Maria,
Maria,
Maria, la milagrosa, Maria.
You are cordially invited to come and see the replica chapel or the sanctuary as a whole.
Now and forevermore.
Ave Maria!
Ako si Victoria Adolfo Mago ay taus-pusong nagpapasalamat sa inyong walang sawang pagsuporta o pagtulong sa Jubel and Friends Foundation Incorporated, lalong-lalo na sa Mama Mary's Prayer Sanctuary.
Hey, dear Mother Mary, come on, let's dance, it's a fiesta. Feliz cumpleaños, Maria.
Maria,
Maria, la milagrosa. Maria, la madre de Dios. Pray for all of us sinners. Now and forevermore, Maria, la milagrosa. Maria.
Again, thank you, thank you, thank you.
All of the sinners, now and forevermore, now and forevermore.
Welcome to our Novena Mass in honor of Mary, the Mother of Jesus, the Emmanuel. Let us join in the singing of our entrance hymn.
We are gathered together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Welcome to our celebration. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We are in preparation for the birth of Jesus. We are doing this novena in honor to our Mother Mary. We are one with her in her preparation for the birth of her Son, Jesus, during Christmas. My dear friends, let us ask God for His blessing. Jesus was called the Emmanuel, which means God is with us. God is always among us. He is present with us right now. I invite you to bow your head and pray for God's blessing. I invite you from your heart and mind, offer your intentions. Wherever you are right now, just pray. Believe on your prayer. Ask God for His blessing, especially this time of Christmas, that God shower us with His abundant blessing. My dear friends, I give you a few seconds to offer your intentions to God. To be worthy in the sacred mystery, let us call to mind our sins and ask God's mercy and pardon. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who are weighed down from of old by slavery beneath the yoke of sin may be set free by the newness of the long-awaited nativity of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, "Ask for a sign from the Lord your God. Let it be deep as the netherworld, or high as the sky." But Ahaz answered, "I will not ask. I will not tempt the Lord." Then Isaiah said, "Listen, O house of David, is it not enough for you to weary men? Must you also weary my God? Therefore the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
The Lord are the earth and its fullness, the world and those who dwell in it. For he founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
Who can ascend the mountain of the Lord? Or who may stand in his holy place? He whose hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
He shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a reward from God, his Savior. Such is the race that seeks for him, that seeks the face of the God of Jacob.
Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
Alleluia, alleluia. O King of David, opening the gates of God's eternal kingdom, come and free the prisoners of darkness. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God. Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This is really a good news for us, because the angel told Mary that there is no impossible with God. Everything is possible. Everything through the power of God, everything is possible. Miracles happen if we put our trust in God, if we put all our faith in Him. We just believe, do not doubt. Everything is possible with the power of God. I know you have all the intentions in our novena masses, and I am praying for your intentions and those intentions entrusted to our prayers. You know, my dear friends, this gospel, the yes of Mary, it's really a good news for us that everything is truly possible by the power of God. My dear friends, allow me to share with you the importance of the yes of Mary in the salvation history. The yes of Mary is the yes to our salvation, because when Mary accepted to be the mother of Jesus, then the salvation has come to all of us, because through Mary, Jesus was born. And that is really a good news to all of us. So, what is the meaning of this yes of Mary to us? First, Mary is the first believer of Jesus. Then we should be like Mary. We should also accept the will of God. Mary said, "I am only the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done as you say." The first invitation for us is to trust. To trust to the providence of God. Just trust. Trust that God will provide our needs. And God is truly providing us our needs. Like Mary, trusting to the Word of God. Trusting to the will of God. And that is the first, that we should have attitude like Mary, trusting to the will of God. Second, the yes of Mary is the yes of being a mother. Being a mother. Being a mother is to nurture, to be a guide to her children. My dear friends, you and I are also given this opportunity to lead people, to nurture people, to take care of people. These people can be our loved ones, can be our workmates, can be our friends. They are gifts given to us. Like Mary, she received a gift of life, and that gift of life in the person of Jesus. We also receive the gift of life. The persons with us right now, they are gifts. They are gifts given to us by God. So, my dear friends, we should also say yes, like Mary, willing to nurture these gifts, to take care of these gifts. It is an invitation for us to say yes. I accepted all these gifts, and I will take care of these gifts. It is an invitation to say yes, to take care of our loved ones and those people entrusted to us. That is an invitation for all of us. My dear friends, let us be grateful that God has showered us with plentiful blessing, abundant blessings. My dear friends, let us imitate Mary, our mother. The yes of Mary, it's a yes, a true yes. First, a yes to the will of God. I will obey, I will follow the will of God. And the second is the yes to take care, to nurture, and to cultivate this relationship with the gifts that God has given. And to us, our yes should be like Mary. Yes to God, I follow your will. And second, yes to God, I take care of my loved ones. I take care of the people with me right now. I take care of my co-workers. I take care of my clients. I take care of my neighbor. I take care of my clan. I take care of the persons entrusted to our care. We nurture them like Mary. So, my dear friends, the yes of Mary is also our yes to God. So at this very moment, I invite you to bow your head and continue to pray for God's blessing. Let us say yes. If we say yes, it is truly yes to God. Yes to God's will. Yes to God's blessing. Yes to God's mission. Yes to God's infinite goodness. And yes to do the will of God. At this very moment, my dear friends, I invite you to pray for the gifts of persons that God has bestowed upon us. Let us remember all the people entrusted to us. I invite you to pray for them. To pray for them. Just pray. I give you a minute of silence to talk to Jesus for your intentions and also for the intentions of your loved ones and those people in trust. entrusted to your care. Just pray, talk to Jesus. This is your time to communicate your needs, prayer requests, intentions to Jesus. For everything is possible with God. Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
May the sacrifice to be offered to you, Lord, make us acceptable to your name, that we may merit for all eternity to be the companions of Christ, by whose death our own mortality was healed, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence. When he came, it is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration. May become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again in glory.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Pablo Virgilio, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our beloved brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at this passing from this life, especially those whom we remember during this Mass, and those souls offered for the intentions of this Mass. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is new. Through through Him, and with Him, and in Him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from
deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Of the world, have mercy.
This is our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen. For our friends joining us today in our online Mass, let us pray the spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. May we receive your mercy in the midst of your temple, O Lord, and show fitting honor to the coming solemnities of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Once again, thank you very much for joining with us in our Novena Masses in honor to our Mother Mary, in preparation for the birth of Jesus. And I do believe that God is granting our request, our intentions, because our Mother Mary is interceding to all our needs. Thank you for joining with us and sharing our Masses to your friends. Thank you, thank you, thank you. please like our FB page if you have not yet liked our FB page, Mama Mary Prayer Sanctuary. And also, subscribe to our YouTube channel, Mama Mary Prayer Sanctuary. In doing so, you are helping us promoting the pilgrimage site, the Mama Mary Prayer Sanctuary in Barangay Akad, Aurora, Zamboanga del Sur, in Mindanao. You are helping in promoting that pilgrimage site by liking our FB page and subscribing to our YouTube channel. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And I am also grateful for your donation. It is a big help in our ongoing construction, the first replica chapel of our Mother Mary, the Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. Thank you, thank you, thank you from my heart. Thank you for helping us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in the service of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The secondary mission thrust of the Jubel and Friends Foundation Incorporated is the Prayer Sanctuary, a place of worship and meditation. The first prayer sanctuary built by the Jubel Foundation is here in Akad, Aurora, Zamboanga del Sur. In this sanctuary is a replica chapel of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. It was constructed in November of 2016. The construction is still going on. To honor our Blessed Mother, the devotees have their 2000 Hail Mary Rosary devotion every Saturday in this chapel. You are cordially invited to come and see the replica chapel or the sanctuary as a whole.
Happy holiday. This season may we never forget the love we have for Jesus. Let him be the one to guide us as another new year starts. And may the spirit of Christmas be always in our hearts.
In every prayer and every song, the community unites, celebrating the birth of our Savior Jesus Christ. Let love.
Ako si Victoria Adolfo Mago, ay taus-pusong nagpapasalamat sa inyong walang sawang pagsuporta o pagtulong sa Jubel and Friends Foundation Incorporated, lalong-lalo na sa Mama Mary's Prayer Sanctuary.
Come and sing a Christmas carol with one big joyful voice, proclaim the name.
Again, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Let's sing Merry Christmas and a happy holiday. This season may we never forget the love we have for Jesus. Let him be the one to guide us as another new year starts. And may the spirit of Christmas be always in our hearts. Let's sing Merry Christmas and a happy holiday. This season may we never forget the love we have for Jesus. Let him be the one to guide us as another new year starts. And may the